One of the big misconceptions in the world is that we understand the species on Earth. We really don't understand biodiversity on Earth, and people think we do, so they don't really investigate it at the level that it deserves. We have this window until things deteriorate further to understand it better, and these kinds of expeditions are about that. I'm Gustav Pauley. I'm curator of invertebrates at the Florida Museum of Natural History at the University of Florida.
Got a very nice Cardean bivalve.
Nice.
So those are hard to get. So that was good. What else?
I got an Abby star and another star.
And an Abby star. Very good. And snails.
Oh yeah, one snail.
Yeah.
We're in the Al Azizi and we are traveling toward Kaus to dock at the end of the mission. We just finished surveying the northern Red Sea and a bit of the outer Gulf of Aqaba for macroinvertebrates, for the larger invertebrate species that live on reefs.
It's been a really successful trip so far. I feel like we've collected a number of different species from a wide range of habitats that I feel are pretty characteristic of the NEOM region. And what's really special is a lot of these are probably new, undescribed species, possibly cryptic species that resemble those elsewhere, or new species that have never before been seen or described.
What's the day look like for us? We groaningly get up at whatever hour we're supposed to get up because we didn't sleep enough. That's the start. Then you stuff your face and have coffee. And then there is usually some leftovers from the night before of specimens that are in various levels of attention that need attention right now or they'll be lost. So the first order of business is to take care of the leftovers and make sure that things are stable, stabilizing the catch from previous days. Once that's done, you can get ready for the first dive. And most days we do two dives. In our case, there are two teams. One team does quantitative work, transects on the reef and deploys the arms and other monitoring structures. And the other team goes out there and collects material for the bioblitz.
My favorite part of being in a bioblitz is after we come back from diving and we get a chance at observing our specimens. In my case, I like to look at small things, so under the stereoscope, looking at all the little things that we find, looking at their color, getting to see the details and how delicate and intricate and colorful everything that we collect can be, is really the most exciting for me.
I found a sponge. I took the sponge. Then I found another sponge and I took the sponge. And every time I find another sponge, and I'm like, you know, the chaperon rouge. It's like, it takes another flower, and the next flower is always more interesting. It's the same with sponge. Sponge.
Oh, what?
Oh! Look, can you see?
What is it?
All the little worms coming out of the sponge.
Oh, wow.
That's the group of worms that I study.
What are they called?
They're called Haplocoelis. It's a genus of worm that's symbiotic with sponges. And that's why I'm so interested in getting sponges. Yeah. It's for the worms.
Yeah.
One of the things bioblitzes can do, and you know, what my life studying biodiversity is about in part, is to get that knowledge that's slowly fading back into circulation by training young people.
That's where it came from.
Yeah, that's the crab came from that.
That's a new species, yeah.
It's a boring sponge that normally is inside the coral, but sometimes it will erupt on the surface. This was a coral, and it just totally erupted on it. See, it ate it.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
You know, it's a really fun trip to be surrounded by folks who are, you know, undergrads, graduate students, postdocs. Most of the people on board this vessel who are working with us are students or postdocs. Chloe is here looking at worms that live in sponges, and we never would have looked in sponges if Chloe wasn't here. And now we have all these worms coming out of sponges. Shoma is here interested in the larvae, so we are doing plankton toes to see what lives in the plankton. And, you know, it's an endless bit biodiversity to a degree. You could spend a lot of time here before you really felt like you got a good chunk of it.
So we have a number of different ways to assess biodiversity besides just collections of different invertebrates. We've also been conducting fish surveys to assess the fish community, as well as deploying arms to assess the sessile cryptic benthic community. These are objects that sit out on a reef for over a year and are then collected, and we look to see what has been growing and living inside.
The rest of the team covers invertebrates, which are the vast majority of diversity on reefs, but when you picture a reef, you really can't picture it with all the fish that are on these coral reefs. They're also very diverse. And that's the part that we're covering with our surveys and collections. We're covering all the fish diversity that we have on these coral reefs.
On this trip, we will end up with about, well, more than 3,000 samples. We all learn from each other, and everybody becomes a better taxonomist, a better biodiversity specialist by doing these trips. And I think that's really important in this day and age when that kind of talent is diminishing.